In this video, I'm going to show you how to turn off auto apply settings in Google Ads and show you my preferred settings to switch on that you absolutely must. It's very easy to get there. All you need to do is make sure you're in the all campaigns for you and you're not in any particular campaign. And just go to the overview and do this. And so what you'll need to do is click in recommendations here and you'll see auto apply. So let's click on that and let's go through them together. So I'll explain what each of these means and when you should turn it on. I won't go through any of the 14 here because I haven't found any performance boost from doing so. In fact, I've found the opposite. So I'm not going to go through these ones, but I'll go through these. Let's hop over to a whiteboard. So the first one is use optimized ad rotation. So Google shows your best performing ads more often instead of evenly rotating all your ads. So if you've got a ad group with three ads in it, three responsive search ads, it will evenly rotate them if you've got this switched off, right? In most cases, like I personally just have one ad in each ad group as a max because responsive search ads already rotate a lot of different headlines and descriptions. And so I turn this on just in case, but I don't really use it, right? So in premise, it's basically if ad A gets more clicks or leads than ad B in a short amount of time, it won't give the others a chance to perform. It'll basically say, this one's performing really well. Let's just give this all of the attention and let's keep showing this best performing one. That's how this works. So I recommend turning it on just in case. Number two is add responsive search ads. So basically Google creates new ads based on your landing page content. And so, you know, if you have something on your landing page, like fast delivery for electronics, Google will use that in your ad copy. And so I recommend turning this on if you need help with your ads and you don't spend that much time in your Google ad account. I personally prefer turning this one off because I like having full control over the ad. And personally, our copywriters beat Google Ads AI any day of the week with the way that it restructures your ad, which we'll get into in the next one, which is improve your responsive search ads. So basically, Google suggests new headlines and descriptions for your ads to make them perform better. So basically, it does use AI using proven headlines that have been used across different industries and verticals. And basically, it will change up your headlines for you if you want to. And so what this does is, like, if you've got like buy affordable shoes in one of your headlines and Google's like, that sucks, let's just do affordable shoes delivered fast because this kind of language has proven to be better. So if you're not really good at words, turn it on, right? If you are better than Google and you understand the nuance of your industry and you're, you know, you know power words, numbers, psychology, science behind headlines, then turn it off and write your own headlines. Don't use this feature. Number four is remove redundant keywords. So basically Google will clean up your keywords list for you if it notices there are similar keywords or duplicate keywords, so that you don't waste your budget. And so if you're running two keywords like buy shoes online and then shop shoes online, Google's smart enough to know that these are the same thing basically semantically, and it will remove one of them for you so that you know, have a cleaner keyword list. So I recommend turning this on because sometimes you don't realize when you add certain keywords to this list. Number five is remove non-serving keywords. So basically Google will automatically remove keywords that haven't been, you know, haven't had performance in a long time. So if you had like luxury garden tools as a keyword and no one has clicked on it in 3 months and, you know, it's barely had any impressions, then Google will remove it for you automatically. Now, in cases where you don't do this, like in most cases, you turn this feature on because it's good. But in some cases, you might be an industry with not a lot of impressions, then it's not a big TAM or big market size. Then sometimes you want to keep this off because it might be the keyword every 6 months that gets clicked on might be the keyword that brought you a $10,000 deal or $100,000 deal. So you might not want to remove certain keywords from your keyword list, even if you know that they're not going to get clicked on once every 6 months or a few months, right? So there is nuance to this one. So be careful with how you apply this one. Number six, remove conflicting negative keywords. So basically, if you have a negative keyword inside of your negative keyword list called cheap or cheap shoes, but in one of your campaigns, you wanted to bid on cheap running shoes and show your ads for that, this is what's called a conflicted negative keyword. So these kind of like cannibalize in a way. Well, not cannibalize, but it kind of stops showing your ads entirely when you want them to show, right? So Google will be smart enough to understand, well, obviously you want to show for cheap running shoes because you're bidding on it. So we will remove cheap shoes from your negative keywords list so that you can keep running your ads. Now, in most cases, turn this on, right? But be very careful of what you're adding to your negative keyword list and adding to your bidding list. Number seven is use optimized targeting. So basically, if you got a performance max campaign and you're targeting people like dog owners, right? And you just didn't happen to add pet owners into your list, then Google will do that for you. It will kind of start expanding the reach and the targeting parameters wider and wider and wider. In most cases, I find this is good to turn on, but if you need to make sure that you've got very strict targeting, like what you find is when it expands, you get worse quality leads coming through, then you might not want to have this turned on because it's just attracting bad quality leads who are outside of your normal audience. So you might want to turn it off in that case. It depends on your niche and industry. If you're in e-commerce, sometimes it's good to turn this on. But if you're a service business who relies on a like lengthy pipeline of sales that takes like 6 months and you need to have hyper-specific audience, then turn this off. Now, number eight, finally, is upgrade your conversion tracking. So Google will upgrade your conversion tracking automatically to data-driven attribution models. So what this means is it will try to attribute your ad, like give the credit where credit is due, really. So if you're on your mobile phone, you're scrolling one day, you see an ad, you click on it, but you don't take action, and then you wait 3 days, and then you come back on your laptop and see the same ad or a similar ad, right? Click on that, same company, and then you start to fill out the lead forms or buy a product, then Google will understand which ad gets credit for that. So a little bit here and a little bit there, like that's kind of how it works. And so in most cases, I turn this on. I like data-driven attribution modeling. I think it's a good one, but there's a lot of pros and cons to different attribution models that you select. There's a lot of opinions in the marketing industry around this. Now, I didn't touch on those other 14 in this video, but again, I don't think they really bring that much performance at the moment. If you've got contrary advice, leave that in the comments below. And if you've got any more questions, leave them in the comments below. I'm happy to answer them. And I will see you in the next one. Cheers.